Juanita Garcia. We will be taking her to St. Jude Catholic Church to celebrate her life, and afterwards she'll be laid to rest at Wildflower Memorial Park. We are going in procession, so please remember to follow close behind and to turn on your hazards and your bright lights as we drive. Before we get to St. Jude, please remember to check your phone. Make sure it's turned down. If you're chewing on gum, please dispose of it. And if you're wearing a hat between here and the church, please remove it upon entry. At this time, we'd like to start in the back of the chapel. You may come forward, say your goodbyes to our sister, and then exit out my double doors to my right. Thank you.
Hi. Señor, confiamente, te lo pido, tu prego, Father, Sister, Santa, Garcia. The heart of the Lord's prayers, the Lord of the Lord's, the Lord of the Lord's, and the Lord's prayers, we pray for all the shortcomings of Santa, Garcia, Peter, every journey, so that God may receive her in his temple. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
In one week of baptism, Santa Garcia died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, you substituted me that your Son who died upon the cross was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all to one for us. Grant that through this mystery, your servant, Santa Garcia, who has got to converse to Christ and share in the joy of his resurrection, we ask this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in the unity of the Holy Spirit. One of those forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
We shall see God as he really is. A reading from the first letter of St. John. See what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called children of God. Yet, so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall see has not been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The responsorial psalm is, O Lord, hear my prayer. O Lord, hear my prayer. Lord, listen to my prayer. Turn your ear to my appeal. You are faithful. You are just. Give answer. Do not call your servant to judgment, for no one is just in your sight. O Lord, hear my prayer. I remember the days that are past. I ponder all your works. I muse on what your hand has wrought. And to you I stretch out my hands. Like a parched land, my soul thirsts for you. O Lord, hear my prayer. Lord, make haste and give me answer. For my spirit fails within me. In the morning, let me know your love. For I put my trust in you. O Lord, hear my prayer. Teach me to do your will. For you, O Lord, are my God. Let your good spirit guide me in ways that are level and smooth. O Lord, hear my prayer. Please rise. Alleluia. Alleluia. whom my Father has blessed, says the Lord. Inherit the kingdom prepared for you since the foundation of the world. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Your faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today morning we are gathered around the altar and we are united in sorrow because our dear sister San Juanita Garcia is no more with us. At the same time, we are also united in faith. We are not only confronted with the reality of death, we are also confronting the reality of faith. In today's Gospel, we read, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God and have faith in me." It is only through the parameter of faith we can understand the meaning of death. We can grieve. A Christian can grieve, but he has to grieve with faith. He or she has to grieve with hope, because we believe, and in every day during the Holy Mass, we profess our faith in the resurrection of the body and the life eternal. So we believe that one day we will be able to meet again our sister San Juanita Garcia. So what we do today is to pray for her. When you recite a rosary or pray an Our Father or Hail Mary for your mother or your grandmother or your great grandmother or your friend or your sister San Juanita Garcia, that prayer lasts into eternity. We know that we pray for the dead because of our love towards that person, and there is always a priority of love or a spiritual reality over the material reality. So when we pray for our dear one, our prayers will go beyond the frontiers of the earth and it will reach heaven. And that's the reason why we pray for the dead. And the church is a communion of three different entities of the church. We, the people of God upon this earth, form the militant church, and the holy souls in heaven form the victorious church, and the souls in purgatory, they form the suffering church. But in Holy Mass, we are united. We are able to be in communion with all sorts of church. So we pray, when you feel the really absent of your sister Swan Hanita, we have to pray to Lord that you feel that absence in your life, and God will make that absence into presence. So today onwards, we are praying for our sister Swan Hanita. Once again, heartfelt condolences and prayers to all the dear ones, especially her children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and the siblings, and all the dear ones. May God bless us all and receive her into his abode in heaven. Amen.
Please stand for the prayer. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voice of those who trust in the Lord, we join our prayers to him. In baptism, our sister received the light of Christ, scattered darkness now and lead her over the waters of the earth. Lord, hear our prayers. Our sister was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of heavenly banquet. Lord, hear our prayers.
We
are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our sister. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your son's coming. Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord,
give us peace and heal our souls. Hear the prayers of the continual Jesus Christ and the voice of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a way into the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of the creation, for through your mercy and mercy, the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of your hands, it is in the forest and the bread of life.
Blessed
are you,
Lord, God of the creation.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of the creation, for the humanness we have received, the one we offer you. Fruit of the garden and work of human hands, which is given to our spiritual children.
Blessed
be
God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, your mighty Father. O Lord, who gave for yourself a people by adoption, through the one sacrifice offered once for all, bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give thanks for the most holy to your universal Jesus Christ, your word, to whom you made all things, whom you sent as the Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and Lord of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and being for your holy people. He stretched out his hands as he feared his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection, and so with angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as we one who is free and free.
Holy,
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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts be prayed by sending down your Spirit to conquer the life that is gone, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at the time he was betrayed and in jail willingly in his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given unto you.
In a similar way, your supper was ended.
he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured for you and for me for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you are with us, worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered in one with the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church. Spread throughout the world and bring them to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Gustavo, Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who are pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and the praise and glory to you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him. O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And the same is command and part of our divine teaching, we therefore say, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. To succeed only for me is a fault.
Thank you. Our pallbearers will follow right behind, and then the rest of our immediate family. may come forward to face her. After they have gone, then we'll invite the rest of our guests and our extended family to come forward to face Earth and to offer your condolences to the family. I want to take a moment to thank you all for coming out and supporting them during this difficult time. Please remember to keep them in your thoughts and in your prayers in the weeks and the months to come. Like I said, it doesn't end today. Go and see them. Go and visit. Bring some pamusa, bring some coffee, bring anything. But your love and your affection, your faith are what the human beings are going to do. So please remember that. Keep them there. Keep them there. Thank you.
it'll really stain your clothes.